Hello, welcome to my channel. Today we have a Jane Doe found August 16th, 1990. It says the estimated age is 26 to 42 years old. She was found in Glynn County, Georgia. Estimated to be about 5'3". Couldn't estimate the weight. She was found in a wooded area off the canal road running parallel to I-95, Glynn County. Not recognizable, near complete or complete skeleton. Doesn't have any hair color or anything like that. Brown leather belt with plastic jewel-like studs. Photos of belt in images on screen. Blue pullover short sleeve shirt, size medium, with white tan horizontal stripes an inch apart and collar. Blue-gray lands and slacks with 27-inch waist. Blue pullover short sleeve shirt, size medium, with white tan horizontal stripes an inch apart and collar. Blue-gray lands in slacks with a 27-inch waist. So if you have anybody that you know that went missing in 1990 that you think that this might be, please contact authorities and let them know. If you have loved ones that went missing, make sure they are entered in NamUs, that the authorities enter them in NamUs. If they're not, try to get the investigators to enter them into NamUs, and also try to get them in the Doe Network. And I don't think you have to go through the investigators for that in the Charlie Project. So, because, you know, this could be somebody that's not even, hasn't even been reported missing, or their case isn't in there. And we'll look at some missing persons, but here's a picture of her. Or, I don't think they had any hair, so I don't know what her hair would have looked like. And they might have, but it doesn't mention it. Doesn't say there wasn't any. But this is a reconstruction artist rendering, I believe, of what she may have looked like. I'm not sure, because it doesn't give an estimated PMI of if it was days or months or how long it was. But it does say estimated year of death is 1990. So, and then here's some missing people. She was only 15 years old, but I'm including her because sometimes I've found the estimated age to be wrong. And here's one of the pictures of her. So you can see the shape of her face and everything. And we'll look at it with hers. So, and like I said, I don't know if it could be somebody that wasn't even reported missing, but I wanted to include her. She went missing from Augusta, Georgia, which is, you know, this is here in Augusta, Georgia. It's a ways away. I will show you. It's 3.5 hours. And 15 years old. The twins, two girls, they were twins, both went missing. They were being followed by a van, and they had asked a couple people to walk them home, and they at last were seen at a pump and go gas station on the corner of 12th Street and Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard, where they bought some chips and drinks. They were never heard from again. It said they had jerry curls to their shoulders. And that's why, when I look at that, I think, oh, because the hair looks like it's shoulder length. So, last seen wearing white tennis shoes. And this is her twin sister. So I don't know if it could be one of them or not, but I didn't want to exclude them. And then this lady, she is multiple. I believe she's like Hispanic or something, but I'm not sure. Such a tiny photo. It just says multiple. Doesn't really give her ethnicity, but Belinda Martinez. Yeah, there it is. White, Caucasian, Hispanic, Latino, 5'4". Victim. says on August 30th, even though this says August 8th. Left her kids with her grandmother, stated she was fed up with the kids and had to get away. When the victim hadn't returned after 5 weeks, the grandmother contacted the sheriff's office. Black hair, brown eyes. Really not sure what her story was or which way she even went. And then we have this lady, Felita Cervantes Rourke. She went missing from Conyers, Georgia, which I thought was, you know, kind of far away. And she allegedly went to meet her ex, or her, I don't know if they were divorced, but they were split up, and she was supposed to meet her ex-husband at McDonald's in Madison, Georgia. She was never heard from again. Her vehicle was found at or near the McDonald's. Black hair, brown eyes. She had gone with a friend, and the friend said that she had left the motel to go meet him, and that she never came back. She's never been heard from again, and he claims he was never supposed to meet her, allegedly. So, and here's a picture of her. And you can see the shape of her face. And that, whoops. There's the shape of her face and the Jane Doe. Anyway, so if you have any information about who this Jane Doe might be, please contact authorities and let them know. If you have any information about what might have happened to any of these missing persons, even if you feel like it's hearsay, you're not sure if it's true, you're not sure if it's accurate, it's not like you're going to testify in a court of law. Please contact authorities and let them know and let them decide what's important and what's not. Don't forget to pray for their families and their loved ones. Feel free to leave comments and have a blessed day. Bye-bye.